Migraine is the one of the most common cause of headache, which is completely preventable and curable, unlike the common notion that it is a very dreaded headache. Good morning, I am Dr. Sushant Eldesani, consultant neurologist in Apollo Hospital, Indore. And today I would like to speak about the myths and the taboos and concerns associated with the most common headache that we come across, the migraine. The dreaded migraine, as we all say, anything under the sun can cause migraine. There are multiple triggers of migraine, which can range from alcohol, nicotine, tobacco, decreased water intake, inappropriate diet, inappropriate timing of food, excessive fasting, excessive use of odor shampoos, perfumes, even excessive medication to treat common headaches can lead to medication overuse headache, which is one of the common type of migraine. Why I want to speak about migraine is because this headache is common in age group of people of 18 to 40 years, and it causes a lot of daily work loss to them. So I choose the topic migraine to speak upon. Patient may present with various symptoms, which are typical symptoms of migraine, of unilateral throbbing headache associated with nausea, vomiting, photophobia, phonophobia. Some people have atypical symptoms of basilar migraine or hemiplegic migraine, where they present with occipital headache or recurrent episodes of loss of consciousness, fall, or even transient weakness in any of the limbs. So these are some typical and atypical but very common symptoms associated with migraine that one should think of. Now coming to its treatment part. So the migraine treatment has two aspects. One is the acute treatment, the instant treatment of migraine, and another is the long-term treatment of the migraine. The instant treatment of migraine revolves around some analgesic drugs, which has to be given only when the headache is severe, so that to taper that episode, but they are not prescribed from long-term prophylaxis. A simple paracetamol can relieve the headache, although there are some other drugs such as triptans, sumatriptans, and rizatriptans, which have been coming and which are used for prevention of acute attack of migraine. To chronically prevent migraine, migraine, as we all know, is a chronic disease. It is present in years and it has fluctuations over months, days. So to prevent that, apart from the medicines, there are some lifestyle changes which I advise to all my patients. One is to increase the fluid intake. At least 3 to 4 liters of water or fluid intake should be there per day. Also, appropriate timing of food. Avoid cheese, Chinese, and chocolate, as they contain substances which increase the frequency and intensity of our migraineous headache. Last but not the least, the behavioral therapies. Yoga, meditation, pranayama, aerobic exercise, in a way, helps treating migraine. For chronic prophylaxis, our drugs range from beta blockers to tricyclic antidepressants to various other therapies which we give. Most important for a patient who is suffering from migraine is to keep a migraine diary with him and to note the exact instances or things related to headache. For example, a patient of mine used to have her migraine headache every time she used to consume tuvar dal. Tuvar dal is a very common ingredient and food in all in our country, but rarely we come across case where this has caused headache. So, by keeping the migraine diary, we came to know that whenever patient used to have this tuvar dal in her lunch or dinner, the headache used to precipitate and she used to have migraineous headache. So I advise all the patients to keep a migraine diary, to note down the points, the previous days, what have they eaten, where have they gone, what things they have used, what things have precipitated their headache, what things they used to do so that the headache can be terminated and they can feel relief. So migraine diary is very important for patients of headache, along with behavioral therapies and chronic treatment. We can and we will overcome our migraine. Thank you.